Saturday. Yeah, you know, they've already been waiting for 4 months, so one more week ain't gonna do anything. Okay, thank you. Sorry about that. Hold on a second here. So, how are you feeling today? Well, first off, my name's Dr. Dalton. Nice to finally meet you here. So, basically, Dr. Henderson has decided to, he told me to tell you that it's called family troubles. But really, he's just like on a family ski trip. And I'll tell you what, them doctors can afford to take even like months off, because they make quite a lot of money. And I can tell you that with confidence, because, you know, I'm just like a sub-in doctor. You know, they just bring me in when they need someone else to do the job. And, looks like we got our work cut out for us today. So, the file says that you called in, following your, adventure in deep space or something along those lines. Is that right? No, Ken, you went to deep space. I didn't even know that was possible. And so, you know, like the NASA Corporation is always, serious about getting people in here, following like a major event. So I heard something happen up there that, was kind of strange. Can you elaborate a little bit on that? Because it'll just help me diagnose you. So, just go ahead, I'm gonna do a few tests here. Really? Making sure your ears are working right. Are you serious? We may have stumbled upon something big here. You're telling me you met alien life up there. Well, how many people have you told? 3 people. Am I the 3rd or am I the 4th? I'm the 3rd. Okay, that's good. Well, you should probably keep this under wraps. Because, like, when this stuff comes out, it's always like a big old hubbub. You know, and everyone's breathing down your neck. So I'm checking you out to make sure everything's okay. So you say you saw some aliens. Well, if you don't mind me asking, were they friendly aliens? Some of them. Okay. Well, hold on, let me do a quick, you know, like, check of your head. And I'm gonna be going around you. Make sure everything's in working order. I'm speaking into your left ear. So, if that sounds good, then we don't need it to go any further with the ears. Seems like you're okay in that regard. owns me. You know, this really ain't my line of work. You know, the nurse should have done this. I just come in here to kind of like talk and use my brain rather than like, well, we're here, aren't we? You know, so we might as well. Okay, we got it off you. I'm gonna throw that thing in the garbage if you don't mind. So what was that thing on your head? It looked like some kind of alien device. Or like, you know, it was moving strange. They're telling me that they was trying to turn you into an alien. With that thing on your head. And you didn't take it off. Make sure it's all off of there. Okay, I think I got all of it. They told you to take it on and get it off. Well, obviously them aliens ain't as bright as, well, me, because I got it off in like 20 seconds. But like, it's neither here nor there. So, I'm gonna have to analyze that thing at the lab. And if you don't mind, I'm gonna call you when we find out what's going on with that thing. Because right now I'm looking at the back of your head. Hold on, let me get back there. And it's looked like you got, you know, like a marking of it. It's almost shaped like a peanut shell. You know, like two ovular shapes converging in the middle. And it's like a red mark, and I don't want you to be worrying about it too much. But, you know, keep it in the back of your mind, if you know what I'm saying. Well, you know, I don't mean to be joking about it, but like it is on the back of your mind, to be honest. So far we got that off the back of your head. Looks like, you know, looking down at your torso and legs. Let me just quickly pull up your pant leg, if you don't mind. You got something down there too. It's like similar. Well, that was similar to the one on the back of your head, but this one was like a purple color. And you know, I don't mean to be rude, but I ain't allowed to show you. Because, well, this is like a foreign new, like, species. And, I could get in trouble for, like, even showing you, even though it was on your body. Let me look at the back of your head one more time. So I'm looking at your earlobes and your ears. And I'm checking out the back of your head here. Yeah. Kind of like a peanut shape. I'll tell you something, I could really go for a bag of peanuts right now. You know, I don't mean to be insensitive about it. But like, you know, I'm hungry kind of. You know, and everything reminds me of food when I'm hungry. Yeah, the other day I seen like a, you know, like a frisbee. They was playing frisbee in the yard. And, well, by God, if that didn't make me think of a nice, big, steaming hot pizza pie. And I had to go get me one of them pizzas. Do you like pizzas? Oh, of course, yeah. I'm sorry, I'm getting off the subject here. You know, I'm trying to keep the mood, like, lighter because, well, we found a new alien species on your head. And, well, it's kind of scary, but, you know, stay calm about it. You know, you're in really professional hands, even though I'm a sub-in. best place, and that's being nice about it. You know, if I was one of them, I'd have a big old, like, house with a swimming pool in the backyard. And, you know, some people want to bring a bunch of people over, but I would like probably hang out by myself and play like PlayStation 4 and maybe swim in the pool with, you know, like a Mountain Dew 2-liter floating next to me. That would be the day. But I'll tell you something, I don't mean to be like insensitive, but you know, after this comes out and they find out about these aliens and the fact that I diagnosed, you know, you with like alien life, you know, they just may bump up my pay increase. And so I hate to look at it in that way, but part of my me does.
Scope. And like, people will be like wondering.
I'm sorry, you know, it's not every day that, well, that you run into, like, someone who has, come in contact with alien life. So, your, legs are clear now. Your, you know, neck and head area is clear. So let me take a quick look at your arms. Okay, this is your right arm. I don't see anything here. Oh, what's that? It's embedded in your wrist. Looks like they embedded you in an alien microchip. And it's just under your wristwatch. So, did you not notice it, or like what? Oh, you thought that, that was just your watch. Because it feels that way sometimes. Yeah, my watch does that too. Like, sometimes I'll lay on it, and it'll, like, dig into my skin a bit. You know, and then, gotta move it so it ain't, like, hurting my wrist a bit. So, let me take a look at this microchip. Okay, we have here a microchip. Check it out. And it's like prime alien technology. It's gotta be. I'll tell you something I knew that we'd find these aliens. And like, I'm so glad we finally found these aliens. Okay, so we got like three organisms, and we got a chip so far. Let me check your left arm. Okay, looks like your left arm is clear. So, like I said before, I'm just a, like a sub-in, and so, I ain't gonna be checking, well, sensitive areas. Due to the fact that they don't pay me enough for that. So, hopefully you've, adequately looked at yourself. And if you do find anything, don't hesitate to give me a call. I'm gonna write down my number for you. You know, in a second. When you sign out of here today, just look at them receptionists and like smile and be that, you know, balance. Hopefully it ain't too bad. And be on your way because we got something big here. Look in your ears one last time. You know, there's a potential for creatures to burrow inside of your ears. Nothing's in your-